Shouldn't you be out going watching football right now?
Well, yeah, but Randy Moss is a free agent as of now, and, well, he's not playing right now, so there's really nothing to watch now anymore, and I'm all sad about it.
Randy Moss
is a free agent when he's the best wide receiver of all time. Is there a reason I'm in this store full of crappy food and unlist prices?
Turn around.
Oh my god, it's Randy Moss! The greatest wide receiver of all time! Oh my god! How you doing today, Dylan? I'm doing well, Mr. Moss. I'm doing well. Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you, too. Hey, Dylan. How you doing today? I'm doing well, unnamed owner. We're just debating on who's the greatest wide receiver of all time. Hey, Dylan. Hey, Lewis. Jerry Rice is the greatest wide receiver of all time, not Moss. You know they were complaining about the end zone because it had too much moss in it? Unnamed owner, how'd you get this filth bag money guy into your restaurant? Dylan, he is not a filth guy money bag. He is a Heisman winning quarterback who will be a first round pick in the NFL. You got that?
Because I've seen enough already. Johnny Manziel is going to be a star as a quarterback in the National Football League because I've never quite seen anything like this combination of talent and skill. I'm not saying he's quite as fast as young Michael Vick was, but he is the most athletic quarterback we have seen since young Michael Vick first took the NFL's breath away. I will remind you that Johnny Manziel last year, after getting off to a slow start in two fewer games than Cam Newton did, shattered Cam Newton's SEC record for total yards. And I will remind you that Johnny Manziel is already, to me, a more consistent passer than Michael Vick is or has ever been. I think Johnny has already shown you he will be a more consistent playmaker than Michael Vick, because Johnny can flat out throw it. He can throw it short and he can throw it long. And if we could see, I don't know if we've shown it yet, that one play in which he fearlessly decided, I'm going at that guy, D. Milliner, who eventually, of course, was drafted number 9 overall by the New York Jets. Remember that corner route he threw to beat Alabama, Nick Saban's defense at Tuscaloosa?